Hallie Laura, you for watching Kate Middleton wears Alexander McQueen at Berlin party. Cheers, Your Majesty. Kate and William raise a glass to the Queen's birthday as Duchess stuns in an off-the-shoulder scarlet gown at a Berlin garden party. She has been dabbling with more daring outfit choices of late, but the Duchess of Cambridge played it safe tonight in a voluminous red gown at a party held in honor of the Queen's birthday. Kate, 35, turned once again to her go-to designer Alexander McQueen, in a chiffon maxi dress currently on sale for £1,453, and a pair of Prada shoes as she arrived at the reception alongside husband William. The couple are attending the sumptuous party at the British ambassador's residence in Berlin for a belated celebration of the British monarch's 91st birthday at the end of their action-packed first day in Germany. The Queen's birthday falls in April, but official celebrations take place later on in the summer, and the British Embassy in Berlin mark it each year with a party, even in the monarch's absence. In a speech tonight, William spoke of his desire for the UK and Germany to remain firmest of friends despite Brexit. He said, "This relationship between the United Kingdom and Germany really matters. It is the product of many years of working closely together. It will continue despite Britain's recent decision to leave the European Union. I am confident we shall remain the firmest of friends." William added, "The United Kingdom and Germany proudly share the same values. Today, we share a fundamental interest in the peace and prosperity of the continent of Europe to which we both belong." This is the second party the couple have attended in the Queen's honor following a lavish soiree in Warsaw on Monday evening, as the 91-year-old monarch continues to delegate public duties including tours to younger members of the royal family. The royals have been warmly received on every stop of their 5-day tour of Poland and Germany so far and, earlier this afternoon, thousands lined the Pariser Platz to catch a glimpse of the royals as they visited Berlin's historic Brandenburg Gate. The couple were cheered as they arrived by around 2,000 people, many in fancy dress, who had stood in sweltering conditions to catch a glimpse of the royal visitors. Some were lucky enough to chat to the Duke and Duchess when they went on a quick walkabout before posing for a picture with the monument in the background. The royal couple spent nearly 20 minutes at the Brandenburg Gate, where they were greeted by the Mayor of Berlin, Michael Müller, and his daughter, Nina. Earlier, the Duchess apologized to Angela Merkel for not speaking German as she arrived for extended discussions with the Chancellor. The Queen, who could not be there tonight, sent out a message from Buckingham Palace, saying, "Prince Philip and I send our warmest good wishes to all of you gathered for this special garden party, on the occasion of the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge's official visit to Germany. We have fond memories of our 5 state visits to Germany, from our first in 1965 to our most recent in 2015. Over the course of those 50 years, British-German relations have thrived, allowing us to face the challenges and embrace the opportunities of the 21st century together. I am delighted that the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge will experience the beauty of this country and the warmth of its people when they visit Berlin, Hamburg, and Heidelberg. I hope you all have a most enjoyable evening." Welcoming the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge to the German Chancery in Berlin, Mrs. Merkel asked Kate if she spoke the language and the smiling Duchess replied, "No, no. Sorry." Kate's lack of German language skills should not pose a problem during the visit, however, as Mrs. Merkel speaks English fluently. Although rarely heard speaking the language in public, Mrs. Merkel revealed her competency when she addressed Parliament during a visit to the UK in 2014. While she may have fallen down on the language front, Kate, 35, as ever showed off her prowess at diplomatic dressing, donning a bespoke Catherine Walker coat and lace dress in the violet-blue shade of Germany's national bloom, the cornflower. Flanked by security, the beaming royal couple shook hands with Mrs. Merkel as a European flag fluttered in the background. The trio stood for pictures on a red carpet before Kate ushered William to stand between herself and Mrs. Merkel for a final pose before heading into the Chancellery for a private meeting. William and Kate spent around an hour with Mrs. Merkel for what Palisades said was an extended discussion and lunch. According to German media, the trio will discuss topics such as European and global politics as well as community service projects over lunch at the Chancellery. German media said the long-planned visit was auspiciously timed as the negotiations on Britain leaving the EU get underway in fits and starts. National broadsheet Süddeutsche Zeitung called the young family Her Majesty's secret weapon and dubbed the German tour a diplomatic mission with the enthusiastic backing of the Foreign Office. They know better than anyone else on the island that the image of the United Kingdom on the continent is not the best at the moment, it said. What could you do in this situation to indicate to your neighbors that Britain is of course a stable nation? Obviously, you send in the royals. News website Spiegel Online called the visit a charm offensive, adding, the royals represent a kind of common sense that this hard ideological government of the Tories seems to have completely lost at the moment, its commentator Thomas Hughland said. Conservative Daily Die Welt called the royal visit to Germany a kind of rescue mission a year after the fateful Brexit referendum which stunned the remaining 27 EU member states. William and Kate are in Germany with their children to lighten the mood, it wrote. The royal couple landed at Berlin Tegel Airport this morning to begin their first official visit to Germany, accompanied by their children Charlotte and George. The three-year-old prince looked less than impressed with proceedings, tugging at his mother Kate's coat to get her attention as she made her way along the receiving line on arrival at Berlin Tegel Airport. The little prince looked in need of a nap, as he rubbed his eyes sleepily and fidgeted as his father Prince William spoke to the welcoming committee. Meanwhile, happy-go-lucky Princess Charlotte, too, was given her own mini spray of flowers by German Gov Rep Till Norn and confidently shook hands with British Defence Attaché Brigadier Rob Ryder. Their arrival in Berlin kicks off the German leg of their five-day tour, with a visit to the Brandenburg Gate and the Holocaust Memorial on the agenda for Kate and William on Wednesday's itinerary. Earlier, the youngster appeared eager to set off on the next leg of the royal tour of Germany this morning, as she tugged her mother's hand to urge her onto their private plane. The two-year-old wasn't keen to waste any time chatting as Kate paused to accept a bouquet of flowers, and was more excited about clambering up the steps of the private plane. Meanwhile, Prince George, who looked shy and reluctant to take part in the official welcome staged by the European nation, was still looking a little overwhelmed as they departed from Warsaw. Kate, 35, looked elegant in a bespoke royal blue coat and lace dress, both by Catherine Walker, with Princess Charlotte matching her mother in a pretty floral frock, teamed with white ankle socks and navy sandals. The adorable little princess tripped along the red carpet on her tiptoes while holding her mother's hand, as George, in his trademark navy shorts and a blue shirt, stayed close to his father Prince William. Once Charlotte had finally torn Kate away, she insisted on scampering up the steps of the plane herself under the watchful eye of her mother, and made it all the way to the top before briefly losing her footing. William and Kate and their children are saying goodbye to Poland, where they have spent the past 2 days celebrating the nation's history, culture, and ties with the UK, and fly to Berlin. So royal watchers will be eager to see if the future king is more at ease when his parents land in Berlin to start the second leg of their five-day trip. On their first day in Berlin, William and Kate held a meeting with Chancellor Angela Merkel before visiting the Brandenburg Gate, the German capital's most famous landmark and a symbol of the country's unification. The royal couple said hello to the crowds gathered on Pariser Platz in front of the gate, before making their way to the Holocaust Museum where they toured the institution and the nearby memorial. Later in the day the Duke and Duchess visited Straßenkinder in East Berlin, a charity which supports young people from disadvantaged backgrounds, including homeless children. They then returned to the west of the city and meet President Frank-Walter Steinmeier at the Bellevue Palace, and in the evening attended the Queen's birthday party held in the gardens of the British ambassador's residence. On their final day in Poland yesterday, the couple paid an emotional visit to the former Nazi concentration camp Stutthof, describing the experience as shattering. The couple toured the former camp in northern Poland where 65,000 people died during Germany's occupation in the Second World War from disease, malnutrition, physical exhaustion, exposure to the harsh climate and abuse from guards, as well as in the gas chamber used to murder those too sick to work, opposite a brick crematorium. After a guided tour of the camp, 20 miles from Gdansk, they had an emotional meeting with two British survivors of Stutthof, Zygi Schipper and Manfred Goldberg, both 87, who were both making their first return to the camp since moving to Britain after the war. Mr. Shipper said William and Kate, who declared they were honored to have met the pair, were clearly very moved by what they saw, adding, "You could see their faces. They were in pain." They then moved on to a medieval market in Gdansk's historic old town where they sampled local delicacies including goldwasser, a traditional liqueur with flakes of gold, and pierogi dumplings. Thousands of locals lined the central market square as the royals arrived to experience a live demonstration of amber processing before trying out local delicacies. As the royal couple emerged from the town hall to the strains of Handel's Zadok the Priest, played at every English monarch's coronation since King George II in 1727, the crowds cheered enthusiastically. Tomorrow, the Duke and Duchess renew their friendly sporting rivalry, that seems to play a part in most of their trips, when they visit the picturesque Germany city of Heidelberg, twinned with Cambridge. William and Kate will on Thursday take to the waters of the River Neckar to cox opposing rowing teams in a race with crews drawn from Cambridge and Heidelberg. Thank you for watching. Please share video and subscribe my channel for more video.